The Glock 19 is a short recoil-operated, locked-breech semi-automatic pistol that uses a modified Browning cam lock system adapted from the high-power pistol. The Glock 19 differs from the Glock 17 in a shorter slide and pistol grip length. It was first introduced in 1988 as a compact version of the Model 17, created for the civilian arms market and for arming various special services and army officers. In this video, we take a look at how the third generation Glock 19 pistol works. The pistol uses a 9x19 caliber and a standard 15-round double-stack magazine. The magazines are made of steel and are overmolded with plastic. The magazine is fixed with a magazine catch located in the pistol grip. The striker firing mechanism has a spring-loaded firing pin. The trigger bar is spring-loaded with a trigger spring. When the pistol is charged, the firing pin is in the half-cock position. As the trigger is pulled, the firing pin is then fully cocked. At the end of its travel, the trigger bar is tilted downward by the connector, releasing the firing pin to fire the cartridge. The connector resets the trigger bar so that the firing pin will be captured in half cock at the end of the firing cycle. This is known as a preset trigger mechanism, referred to as the safe action trigger by the manufacturer. The connector ensures the pistol can only fire semi-automatically. The firearm's locking mechanism uses a linkless, vertically tilting barrel with a rectangular breech that locks into the ejection port cutout in the slide. During the recoil stroke, the barrel moves rearward, initially locked together with the slide until the bullet leaves the barrel and chamber pressure drops to a safe level. A ramp lug extension at the base of the barrel then interacts with a taper locking block integrated into the frame, forcing the barrel down and unlocking it from the slide. This camming action terminates the barrel's movement while the slide continues back under recoil, extracting and ejecting the spent cartridge casing. The slide's uninterrupted rearward movement and counter-recoil cycle are characteristic of the Browning system. The slide features a spring-loaded claw extractor, and the stamped sheet metal ejector is pinned to the trigger mechanism housing. Glock pistols lack a traditional on-off safety lever. Instead, the pistols are designed with three independent safety mechanisms to prevent accidental discharge. The system, designated safe action by Glock, consists of an external integrated trigger safety and two automatic internal safeties, a firing pin safety and a drop safety. The external safety is a small inner lever contained in the trigger. Pressing the lever activates the trigger bar and sheet metal connector. The firing pin safety is a solid hardened steel pin that, in the secured state, blocks the firing pin channel. It is pushed upward to release the firing pin for firing only when the trigger is actuated and the safety is pushed up through the backward movement of the trigger bar. The drop safety guides the trigger bar in a ramp that is released only when direct rearward pressure is applied to the trigger. The three safety mechanisms are automatically disengaged one after the other when the trigger is squeezed, and are automatically reactivated when the trigger is released. After the last cartridge has been fired, the magazine follower presses on the slide stop lever and the slide remains open on the slide stop. The Glock 19 has a fixed polymer sight arrangement that consists of a ramped front sight and a notched rear sight with painted white contrast elements. rear sights can be adjusted horizontally. At the end of the video, I would like to tell about some myths of Glock pistols. The first polymer-framed pistol was not the Glock 17 at all, it was the H&K VP70. But Glock can be called the most famous and popular polymer-framed pistol, which has given rise to many myths. The first myth is that polymer is fragile and unreliable, but it is not so. The Glock's frame, magazine body, and several other components are made from a high-strength nylon-based polymer invented by Gaston Glock, called Polymer 2. This plastic was specially formulated to provide increased durability and is more resilient than carbon steel and most steel alloys. Polymer 2 is resistant to shock, caustic liquids, and temperature extremes where traditional steel or alloy frames would warp and become brittle. The second myth is that the polymer construction of the pistol is invisible to metal detectors or X-rays. In actuality, 84% of the gun's weight is from steel, and polymer 2 is visible to X-ray machines. The myth's prevalence is believed to be connected to a scene that perpetuated the myth in film Die Hard 2, which released a few years after the Glock was invented. The third myth relates to the numbering of pistol models. Many people mistakenly believe that the Glock 17 was so named because of its magazine capacity, but this is not the case. The Glock 17 was named after the number patent filed by Gaston Glock during the development of the pistol. This was his 17th patent. In the video, I used footage from the game World of Guns. You can find this game on Steam, Google Play, or the App Store. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video and want to help the channel, then just subscribe and like it.